Belinda Audiobooks presents this unabridged recording of Aussie Bites, read by Stig Weems. Be sure to check us out on the web at www.belinda.com. Crackle. Earl had learnt a little bit about electricity at school, but he hadn't heard of anyone waking up with electrified hair before. What was supercharged Earl going to do? Crackle by Margaret Clark. The dedication reads, for Ben, who helped with the editing and the ideas, and a huge thank you to Sharon Gilhooley and Class 4G at Eltham Primary School for giving suggestions and encouragement for Crackle. Chapter 1. When Earl woke up one morning, he felt weird. He frowned. Something wasn't right. What was it? His head felt funny. Something was wrong with his hair. He touched it with his hand. It felt spiky. He jumped out of bed and looked in the mirror. His hair was standing straight up, bristling like a huge toothbrush. He tried to pat it down, but it sprang back to attention again. Maybe putting water on his hair would help. So Earl walked down the passage towards the bathroom. His sister Rena was just coming out. It was a miracle. She usually hogged the bathroom for ages. Earl, you little creep. You've been messing with my hair gel, she said when she saw his hair. How many times have I told you to leave my stuff alone? I wouldn't touch your hair gel with a gold-plated comb dripping with diamonds, said Earl. And has anyone ever told you that you wear too much eye makeup? You look like a raccoon. Rena the raccoon. While she was still thinking about that, he dodged past her into the bathroom and snibbed the door. Then he stared at his hair in the mirror. He looked like an extremely angry echidna. He put his head under the tap until his hair was wet. It made a strange crackling sound. What was going on? He looked in the mirror again. His hair was still standing off his head as if it was being pulled by a gigantic magnet. Earl got under the shower nozzle and turned the water on full blast. His hair crackled and pinged alarmingly as he tried to shampoo it. It wasn't April Fool's Day, but someone was playing a joke. It had to be Rena. She'd played a trick. That was it. She'd probably sneaked into his room and sprayed his hair with wood varnish or something while he was asleep. Once she'd put a dead toad on his head while he was asleep. Another time she'd put slime on his sheets. That was a long time ago. She hadn't played any tricks for ages. He got out of the shower, dried himself, and went back to his room. As he got dressed, he decided the best thing to do would be to ignore the joke. That would really get up Rena's nose. He'd pretend that everything was normal. Chapter 2. Earl? Shrieked Mum. What have you done to your hair? I didn't do anything. Rena looked up from her bowl of rice bubbles splashing with super low-fat milk and pulled a face. You look stupid, she said.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.